वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने सोमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणमिदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। So we are looking at the 217th avarta, where the Chaitanya Prakara is discussed and also based on the Abhasavada and Avachedavada, a comparison is made as to who is the Pramata. The conclusion of Sadhu is that Abhasavada is better than Avachedavada because it answers all questions and there are no possibilities of doshas which have been indicated, such as the insentient also becoming Pramata because of the definition lacking abhasa. Antakkarana vishishta chaitanyam pramata, if you say that, then what will happen is that antakkaranam being bhutakaryam, panchamahabhutakarya, ghatadi jagat is also panchamahabhutakarya. Therefore, panchamahabhutakaryatvat ghatadi vishishta chaitanyam api pramata bhavati. That is a dosha which is not there in Abhasavada. Therefore, Abhasavada is Shreyan. Further, in the 218th Avarta, Pramatradi Chaturvida Chaitanya Swarupam. What is the Swarupa of Pramata Ityadi, Pramata, Pramana, Prameya? यथा अंतकरणम आभास सहितम एव आस्ते तथा तद्वृत्ति ही अपि आभास सहिता एव जायते। जस्ट लाइक अंतकरण कैनॉट बी विदाउट आभास, इट हैज ऑलवेज टू बी अलोंग विद आभास, वेदर इन द स्थूल शरीर और नॉट। इवन इफ इट इज नॉट इन द स्थूल शरीर, आभास विल बी देयर इन सुषुप्ति ऑल्सो, आभास विल बी देयर in pralaya also, abhasa will be there. After marana also, abhasa will be there in the antakarana. That is the jiva, pramata jiva. Pramata, when there is a possibility of objectification. Only when the antakarana, sukshma sharira, gets a stula sharira, what we call a janma, then alone the jiva can become a pramata by objectifying a prameya. Otherwise, the abhasa sahita antakkaranam is always there. That is the one which transmigrates, has a samsarana across shariras. So, antakkaranam abhasa sahitam eva yatha aste. Tatha, similarly, tad vritti api. When will the vritti take place? When there is a vishaya. Whenever there is a prameya vishaya, then the antakkarana goes to that vishaya. If that vishaya is outside, if it is within, then the antakkarana remains inside. While remaining inside, it goes outside as well in the form of vritti, dirghi bhava that we saw, towards the object and takes the vishayakaram, that is called as vritti. So tad vritti api abhasa sahita eva, because antakarana always has abhasa, the vritti when formed will also have abhasa, being the modification of antakarana. That is chitta vritti. The yogis talk about chitta vritti nirodha. This is that vritti, chitta vritti or antakarana vritti, which always has an abhasa. As and when the vritti comes up, antakarana modifying in the form of vritti, ekadesha of antakarana, then that vritti will also have abhasa chaitanya. Abhasa sahita vritti vishishta chaitanyam pramana chaitanyam ityuchyate. So that is the pramana chaitanya. What is pramana? Which we say as pramana. Everything is chaitanya. Therefore, pramana is also chaitanya. Pramana chaitanya is that kind of chaitanya which is abhasa sahita vritti vishishta. So earlier, antakarana vishishta, what kind of antakarana? Abhasa sahita, which is understood now. So even if we just say antakarana vishishta chaitanyam pramata, then it has to be understood that it is abhasa sahita antakarana vishishta chaitanyam pramata. Similarly, abhasa sahita vritti vishishta chaitanyam is pramana chaitanyam. Then what is prama ityadi further? Ghatadi vishyakara antakarana vrityarudham chaitanyam prama iti yathartha jnanam iti va uchyate. So what is yathartha jnanam or prama? Yathartha jnanam is as it is in keeping with the vishaya. It is vastu tantra. The way the vastu is, that is how the understanding takes place. That kind of vrityaruda chaitanya is called as prama. Prama is agantuka, agantuki. The prama comes up and goes, although it is chaitanya, the chaitanya doesn't come and go. It is nitya. But we have seen vritti comes and goes. And that kind of vritti, vishishta chaitanya, where this vritti comes and goes, can be pramana as seen earlier, and it becomes prama when it takes ghatakara. The vritti which takes dirghi bhavad, antakarana becoming dirgha, extending towards the vishaya, that is vritti. That vritti vishishta chaitanya is pramana, which is abhasa sahita. Then this vritti vishishta chaitanya, which has taken that dirghi bhava, that kind of antakarana, when it takes the vishayakara, that vishyakara antakarana vrityarudham chaitanya, which is the vishaya ghatadi, any vishaya which is outside or inside, it can be Brahma also. Ghatadi vishaya akara antakarana vrityarudham chaitanyam prama. Then that vrityaruda chaitanyam is called as prama, which was earlier pramana. Same, look at this, the same pramata. First of all, chaitanya is one. That same chaitanya is called as pramata, prameya, pramanam, prama. These four divisions we have seen. Based on what is the adjective there, visheshana, which is added. If it is an upadhi, this chaitanya remains a sakshi. When it is divided, so-called division takes place in chaitanya, when it is divided, that time, there is a qualification, same chaitanya. So when it is getting qualified with antakarana, which has abhasa, then becomes a pramata. It is the same pramata who has antakarana. This antakarana, when it goes out or goes towards the vishaya, whether outside the body, whether outside the body or within the body, when the antakarana goes towards the vishaya, objectifying the vishaya, then the vritti which is taking place, that is also modification of antakarana. Which antakarana? The same antakarana which is a visheshana to the chaitanya, who is a pramata now. that pramata's antakarana becomes the vritti as it extends towards the vishaya, that vritti aruda chaitanya, the vritti vishishta chaitanya, which is abhasa sahita, is pramana. This same vritti vishishta chaitanya, when it takes the vishayakara, whether it is ghatadi vishaya or sukadukhadi vishaya or brahma as vishaya, brahmatma as vishaya, brahmakara vritti, atmakara vritti, any of these vishayas become the subject matter of the vritti. I'll not say an object, because the brahma cannot be objectified. It's a vishaya in the sense it is a subject matter really. When it takes the that akara, for a lack of better word, it has to be said as akara. Then the same vritti, which is from the antakarana's modification, which antakarana is qualifying the chaitanya to make a pramata, that is now called as prama, because it is in keeping with the vishaya. This vishaya, in the case of Rajju Sarpa, if it is Rajvakara, then it is Prama. If it is Vishayakara, but not Rajvakara, it is Sarpakara, then it is Brahma. In both cases, there has to be a vritti, which has abhasa again. So this is the broad overview, because the definitions can get confusing. So I am giving a distinction a priori so that there is no confusion. It is the same pramana which is called as prama when it becomes valid. So here ghatadi vishayakara antakarana vrityarudam chaitanyam pramaiti yathartha jnanam itiva uchyate, when it is in keeping with the vishaya. Pramayaha sadhanam indriyam pramanam iti kathyate. So the pramana which has been explained earlier as being abhasa sahita vritti vishishta chaitanya, that is a sadhana to prama. In the case of indriya janya prama, the pramanam is indriyam. So pramayaha sadhanam indriyam pramanam iti kathyate. It's a means to prama. So the means to prama is pramakaranam pramanam. We have seen this definition earlier. Atredam nyeyam. Here we have to understand if there is a difference or commonality. Vishyakara vrityaruna chaitanyam pramaiti kirtyate. What is prama and what is pramana? Pramana is sadhana for prama. And vishyakara vrityaruna chaitanyam pramaiti kirtyate. Now he is simplifying it. What is this vishyakara vritti? Ghatadi vishaya. What is vritti? Antakkarana vritti. So he has dropped the ghatadi, because ghatadi is in samanadikranit vishaya, karmadharya. Antakkarana and vritti, the word antakkarana is dropped because vritti is always of antakkarana. So it is understood, he is making it simple. Vishyakara, which is already there here. Ghatadi has been dropped. Vritti. Vritti is there in the earlier definition. Antakkarana is dropped to make it simple. Vishayas we know. Vritti we know as antakkarana vritti, chitta vritti. So simple definition is vishayakara vrityaruda chaitanyam prama. Aruda we can see as some kind of connection. Aruda we can say chaitanya is aruda on the vritti, or chaitanya is within the vritti, avachinna. These are the different words used. Both are okay, avachinna or aruda. They have a similar shade of meaning. In the context, they have a similar shade of meaning. So prama iti kirtyate. Tatra chaitanyasya swarupataha nityatvat na indriya janyatva sambhavaha. Chaitanya is nitya, swarupataha nitya. Therefore, chaitanya is not indriya janya. It is impossible that chaitanya will be indriya janya. So what is indriya janya? Although prama is also chaitanya, prama is indriya janya, chaitanya is not indriya janya. So it is a figurative way to say that Chaitanya is generated. Because Prama is generated, you have to say Chaitanya is generated. Chaitanya is not generated. Chaitanya, which is qualified in a particular manner, that qualification being Janya, Indriya Janya, it appears that the Chaitanya is Janya. Because there is some kind of sentience which is borrowed from the Chaitanya, which is your own Swarupa. Brahma Chaitanya, Brahmatma. So tatra chaitanyasya swarupato nityatvat na indriya janyatva sambhava atascha prama chaitanyam prati indriyasya yadyapi sadhanatvam na yujyate eva tathapi upacharena indriyasya prama sadhanatva vyavaharaha. So the vyavahara of prama having a sadhana in the form of pramana, which happens to be indriya in the case of pratyakshadi prama. In pratyaksha pramana is there, which happens to be indriya, chakshuradi indriya. And this prama comes and goes, therefore pramana or indriya is said to be a sadhana. Otherwise, chaitanya does not need indriyas. Atascha prama chaitanyam prati, towards this prama chaitanya, not chaitanya, prama chaitanya, indriya, yadyapi sadhanatvam na yujyate indri. Prama chaitanyam is chaitanya. Being chaitanya, for prama chaitanyam, indriya cannot be sadhana. Because of being, why? Chaitanyatva. Being chaitanya. Why? Chaitanyatva nityatva. Chaitanyasya nityatva. Prama chaitanyam prati indriyasya. Sadhanatvam yadyapi na yujyate. Tathapi upacharena. There is an upachara. A figurative usage. To explain a vyavahara, it is said that indriya is pramasadhana. Tathahi upadhi shunya chaitanye pramavyavahara abhavat vishyakara vrityupaita chaitanye eva tad vyavaharacha chaitanye pramashabda pravrutto vishyakara vrittehe upadhitvat tasyaha vrittehe indriya janyatvat tadrusha vrityupaita pramam pratiyapi indriyasya sadhanattu vyavaharaha. So this indriya, which is pramana, is karana, is asadharana karana, is sadhana towards prama, which happens to be prama chaitanya. There the usage is vyavaharika usage. It is not really coming and going. Chaitanya is there. There is an abhasa. There is a pratiti of Chaitanya, sentience really, coming and going. In keeping in the Vishaya changes, it appears that the earlier Prama has gone, a new Prama has come up. So Prama is Chaitanya. So we have to say that Prama Chaitanya earlier was different than the Prama Chaitanya now. This usage is figurative. And thereby sadharatva yavahara of indriya is also figurative. So upadhi shunya chaitanya, the chaitanya which cannot have an upadhi even. Really, what is upadhi? Upadhi will distinguish without having anvaya with chaitanya, that which distinguishes it from other chaitanya. There is no other chaitanya, there is only one chaitanya, which has to be differentiated in each and every jiva. Therefore, some upadhi is mentioned. When it becomes a visheshana, that sakshi chaitanya, individual sakshi chaitanya, will become jiva, pramata. But the chaitanya can neither have a visheshana nor have an upadhi. So upadhi shunya chaitanya, prama vyavahara bhavat, you cannot have Prama Chaitanya usage also, that usage is figurative. Even if you take Prama as an Upadhi, not as a Visheshana to Chaitanya, the Chaitanya is really Upadhi Shunya. But still, Prama Vyavahara Bhavadapi, Vishyakara Vrityupaita Chaitanya Eva Tad Vyavaharacha. Where is the usage possible? Vishyakara Vrityupaita Chaitanya Eva. When you say Prama Chaitanyam, really what is prama? Prama has been defined as vishayakara vrutya arudha chaitanyam. So there has to be vishayakara vrutti, that vrutti is agantuki. It comes and goes in keeping with the vishaya. This vishayakara vrutti, when seen in connection with chaitanya, then vishayakara vrutti becomes an upadhi to chaitanya. Therefore, vishyakara vrutyupaita chaitanye eva tad vyavaharacha. What vyavahara? The upadhi vyavahara is possible. Prama vyavahara bhavat. Chaitanye prama vyavahara bhavat. Vishyakara vrutyupaita chaitanye eva prama vyavaharasya sambhavat. The vyavahara, any qualification is possible only with respect to upadhi shunya, it shouldn't be upadhi sahita. So upahita chaitanya alone can take the can take the prama shabda also. Vyavahara is also possible with a upahita chaitanya, not upadhi shunya chaitanya. Therefore, what is this upadhi now? Vishyakara vritti upahita chaitanya. Vishyakara vritti is the upadhi to chaitanya, and that chaitanya is called as prama. Chaitanya prama shabda pravruttau. Then chaitanya prama shabda pravruttau, when there is a pravruttau satyam, when there is a pravritti, when we use, so pravritti there is vyavahara. When there is vyavahara, when you talk about prama shabda, then that prama shabda, when it is talked about with respect to chaitanya, vishayakara vruttehe upadhitvat tasya vruttehe indriyajanyatvat tadrusha vruttyupahita pramam prati api indriyasya sadhanatva vyavaharaha. So the pramana also, when you say indriya is pramana for prama, then it is not the upadhi shunya chaitanya which is called as prama, towards which the indriya becomes a pramana or sadhana. What is it sadhana towards? It is sadhana towards vishayakara vritti, vishayakara vrittehe upadhitvat. It is the indriya is a sadhana or pramana towards what now? Towards tadrusha vritti upahita pramam prati indriyasya sadhanatvam. Indriya is sadhana towards prama, but what prama? Not this upadhi shunya chaitanya which is called as prama chaitanya, but vritti upahita prama. Vritti upahita prama has indriya as sadhana. Why so? Because that kind of vritti alone is indriya janya vishayakara vrittehe upadhitvat. And that vrittehe indriya janyatvat, vritti being indriya janya, and that vritti which is vishayakara vritti becomes an upadhi to chaitanya. Therefore, towards that vritti there is indriya janyatvam, and therefore that vritti upahita prama has indriya as sadhana. Anyway, this is known, but it is clearly mentioned. People get confused as to what is pramana, what is prama, what is prama chaitanya. So as soon as the word chaitanya comes in, people get confused. So it is not the chaitanya which is agantuka. It is not the chaitanya which has pramana. It is not the chaitanya which has sadhana, which has indriyas, but it is only the upadhi which has the sadhana of indriyas, which has pramana. And this upadhi happens to be, in this case, it happens to be prama, which is defined as vrittyupahita. So vrittyupahita chaitanya is that which comes and goes, not chaitanya, the vritti part comes and goes, and therefore has a sadhana of indriya, which becomes a pramana. Okay, so enough of this prama. इत्थम एव इंद्रियम प्रमासाधनम इति व्यवह्रियते. देयरफॉर प्रमासाधनम किम, प्रमासाधन इज इंद्रिया बेस्ड ऑन प्रत्यक्ष. राइट नाउ द एग्जांपल हैज बीन टेकन ऑफ प्रत्यक्ष, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, बट दिस इज अ ब्रॉड डेफिनेशन इन कीपिंग विद द एग्जांपल ऑफ प्रत्यक्ष. अदरवाइज इन अदर केसेस इंद्रिया in case of pratyaksha also, pratyaksha is aparoksha, and although this is in the vyavahara where indriyas are involved, still it has to be understood that all the time indriya may not be involved. Anyway, it will be discussed further. Kintu shariranthastham antakaranam vishaya roopa ghatadidesha paryantam dirghi bhava patti roopam parinamam prapnoti. We have seen this earlier, so now I can speed through. The antakarana extends towards the vishaya. Generally, when it is outside, it goes through the indriya golaka outside. When it is within, it remains within with the indriya golaka, going through the indriya golaka. Sometimes when indriya is not involved, it remains inside but has a vritti. That extending towards the vishaya is called as dirghi bhava, and dirghi bhava patti rupam parinamam prapnoti sah parinama, that parinama eva pramanam ityuchyate. So the earlier definition is elaborated here, is explained here. Vishayihi sah militasya antakaranasya vishaya samana karaha yaha parinamaha tasya pramayati vyapadeshaha. And this extended vritti, extended antakarana, which is called as vritti, extended towards the vishaya, when it takes the vishaya akara, it is called as prama. Shariranta sthita antakarana desha marabhya ghatadi vishaya desha paryantam dirghi bhutasya antakaranasya parinamaha prama rupatam dhatte. So it is the same dirghi bhava of the antakarana, which has extended from within the sharira to outside the sharira in the example of ghata or some shabda ityadi, which is outside, but not in the case of rupa and rasa. In the case of gandha also questionable, we'll leave it open. Wherever the vishaya is, it goes there outside, because generally the vishaya will be outside the nose. Unless you are putting some medication within the nose, it will be outside. In any case, based on wherever the vishaya is, that dirghi bhava is called as vritti of antakarana, and that dirghi bhava apanna vritti, that vritti which has already taken dirghi bhava, antakarana which has already taken dirghi bhava, called as vritti, called as pramana, it is sadhana for prama, so it will generate prama. So prama janyatvam is that in that dirghi bhava apanna antakarana, called as vritti, it becomes a pramana, and being a sadhana, it generates something. What is that? It generates prama. And how does it generate prama? When it takes the vishayakara. So as soon as that same vritti takes the vishayakara, the vritti gets another name as prama. Earlier it was called as pramana, and that pramana generates an akara in itself. That generated akara in the vritti is called as prama. So shariranta sthita antakarana desham arabhya, beginning within, from the sukshma sharira antakarana ghatadi vishaya desha paryantam, towards the vishaya, dirghi bhutasya antakaranasya parinamaha, antakarana modifying, elongating towards the vishaya, that modification gets pramarupa. So pramarupatam dhakte. Tasmat pramayaha pramana rupa antakrana vrittescha na adhiko bheda asti. So there is no bheda, not much difference between the pramana and prama. That is why jnanam, when you say jnanam, jnanam can be pramana also, jnanam can be bhave yutpatti also, it can be prama also. That is why yut is bhave and karane cha. Karane adhikarane cha, but generally karane. You don't think of buddhi when someone says jnana. When you say jnana, then Jnana is a means to something, or Jnana is something which is born out of a means. Both are possible. There is not much difference between the two. So Jnana Sadhanam Jnanam. When you say Jnana Sadhanam Jnanam, then Jnanam, the second Jnanam is Pramana, and first Jnanam, which is Jnana Sadhanam, the Jnana sitting in Jnana Sadhanam, has Bhavi Vipatti. The second has Karane Vipatti. Both have Lit Pratya. Akartari cha karake sanyaya, but bhave vitpatti and karane vitpatti, both are possible. Here, prama has a different, of course, madhatu, prapurvaka madhatu exists in both, but different pratyas are used. Jnanam has the same pratya also, but difference in meaning. And what does he say? Tasmat pramayaha pramana rupa antakrana vrtyescha nadhiko bhedosti. There is not much difference between pramana and prama. Because it is the same vritti which is pramana modifying into an akara, taking an akara. It is already modified form of antakarana, but it takes vishayakara. Okay, this is quite a lot of granularity. Hopefully it will clarify the entire prakriya. Now let's go through the sum up. Anena kramena bahya padarthanam pratyaksha jnanotpatti dashayam antakarana vrittihi बहिर निर्गत्य विषयी भूत घटादि समानाकारातम आकृतम धत्ते. सो विषयी भूत घटादि समानाकारातम धत्ते व्हाट द अंतकरण वृत्ति. अंतकरण वृत्ति, अंतकरण एक्सटेंड्स आउट, गोस टू द विषय, इट इज कॉल्ड एज वृत्ति. देन इट टेक्स द विषयाकार, इट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रमा. शरीरांतस्थम शरीरांतस्थात्मनः प्रत्यक्ष काले तु. Now, this was pratyaksha of the vishayas outside, or inside also we can say ghatadi vishaya, shabdadi vishaya. But what about pratyaksha happening within? Shariranthasthatmanaha pratyaksha kaletu antakkarnavritti bhair nirgamanam vina. Sharirasya antara eva atmakaratam dhatte. What happens in brahmakara vritti? Atmakara vritti. So the atma or brahma becoming pratyaksha, what is called as sakshatkara. What happens then? He says shariranthastha atmanaha. Atma is supposed to be within. That's why he has used atma word, not brahma. When we talk about atma, generally it is pratyakatma. Only when it is understood as Brahma, then the limitations of the Sharira go away. But before the limitations, cognitive limitations of Atma go away, one understands as Atma being within. So Atma is within. Shariranthastha Atmanaha Pratyaksha Kali, when that becomes Pratyaksha, called as Sakshatkara, Atmanubhava, Anubhuti. All these words are interchangeable. Aparoksha Jnana. Then, Pratyaksha Kaletu Antakrana Vrittihi Bahir Nirgamanam Vina. Without going outside, Sharirasya Antarayeva, being within itself, Atmakaratam Dhatte. It takes the Atmakara. So, Antakrana undergoes modification, called as Vritti. That Vritti is also called as Pramana, which becomes a sadhana towards prama. That prama is the same vritti taking the akara of atma. Taya atma karaya vrittya atma shritam avaranam nivartyate. Thereby what happens is that avarana, which is one shakti out of the two, avarana shakti. Avarana is a parinama. Avarana is an effect of that shakti which causes avarana. Avarana shakti means avarana causing shakti. That avidya or ajnana which causes avarana veiling on the atma is taken out by this vritti. Atmakara vritti. So atmakaraya taya vrittya atma shritam avaranam nivartyate. We have seen atma is the ashraya of avarana also. So Atma Shrita Mahavarnam Nivartyate is taken away. Atma Swasya Prakashana Vrittav प्रकाशते. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज वृत्ति व्याप्ति. देन आत्मा स्वस्य प्रकाशने वृत्तौ प्रकाशते. देयर नो फल व्याप्ति इज नीडेड. वी डोंट नीड द चैतन्य टू बिकम वन बिटवीन विषया एंड दी विषयी, बिटवीन द सब्जेक्ट एंड दी ऑब्जेक्ट, प्रमातृ एंड दी प्रमाता एंड दी प्रमेय. द चैतन्य बिकम्स वन व्हेन इट इज घटादि विषय. बट हियर द content of the pramata and the content of the vishaya, which is atma, happens to be the same. Therefore there is nothing else needed. Happens to be the same, not only same, it is, there is no need for any other prakasha. Ghatadi vishayas need prakasha, so vritti needs to be lit up. Here you don't need to light up the vritti, because vritti is atmakara, atma is prakashavan. Swayam prakasha, prakashavan is swayam prakasha in the case of atma. Elsewhere prakasha may be borrowed, it may not be same as the swarupa, it may be a guna. Here it is not a guna, prakasha is jnana, chaitanya. So atma swasya prakashana, here it is raho shira with shashti. Swasya prakashana vritto prakashate, so it shines up in the vritti by itself. Nothing else is needed, because avarana goes up, it shines. We have seen the earlier example earlier, when there is, in a dark room, there is a light kept, but covered with a pot. Then due to the dark room, you neither see the pot, nor do you see the light which is hidden within. Then, even when you light up, you still need to take out the veil. So when you take out the veil, then alone so actually it was multiple levels were given. So even if you break the pot, if there is an outer pot and inner pot which veils a source of light, then the outer pot breaking also, you still need the inner pot to be taken away. So you see in some kind of an example where the, once that veil is removed, the light shines on its own. You don't need a separate the switch in the room. You don't need to switch on a separate light in the room, because the lamp shines forth on its own. Anyway, two ghatas are not needed. It was in that specific example as to why something which is already a product of ajnana, why does it need to be veiled again? So in that case, it was seen. So atma swasya prakashana vritto prakashate anenaiva nimittena atma vritte vishaya ityuchyate. So atma is vritti vishaya, not as an object. It is called as a vritti vishaya because of this nimitta, because it shines up only after the vritti takes place. It shines up in the vritti. Without the vritti, atma cannot be known. First, there has to be a vritti. Vrittista chidabhasa rupa phalasya tu atmana vishayo bhavati. However, it is not a vishaya of vrittista chidabhasa rupa phala. Atma is not a vishaya of the vrittista chidabhasa rupa phala. There is no phala vyapti needed. That is what is said here. Varnitena prakarana sakshi rupa atma swayam prakasha rupa bhati iti siddhyati. So way to understand the earlier this vishaya atma vishaya na bhavati of vrittista chidabhasa rupa phala, meaning phala vyapti is not needed. We have seen the example of the sunlight falling on the mirror, and you shine the mirror on some vishayas, there that can be called as phala vyapti. There is a dark room, there is a pot kept in the room, but there is some beam of light, sunlight coming from a particular, you know, a particular, let's say, hole in a wall or a something like that. There's a beam that you see, but it can light up only wherever the beam is. The sunlight can only light up that area. You have ghatadi elsewhere. You take a mirror and shine that light which is coming in, that sunlight, onto the ghata. Then the ghata is visible. That is phala vyapti. Ghata is there, On that, if there is a cloth also, you remove the cloth, you cannot see there is phalavyapti needed. That phalavyapti is a light falling. Now this light falling is the reflected light of sunlight. It is not the sunlight itself. So that is the chidabhasa, vrittista chidabhasa roopa phala. In the example, it is the darpanastha surya kirana roopa phala. When you project the sunlight through the mirror, using the mirror onto the ghata shines forth. Now, let's say the sun itself is the vishaya. You want to shine the sun, or let's take a bulb. Sun would be crazy, you know, lot of distance. But let's say there's some light source which you are reflecting nearby, and you turn that light source towards the light. Turn the darpana mirror towards the light. So the reflection is falling on the light. Is that reflection contributing to revealing the light? It isn't. The original light reveals itself. You don't need to. Even if you change the mirror direction and you shine it upon the source itself, it's not going to do anything. So that means the original lamp source does not need the reflected light source, which is called as phalavyapti in this case. Varnitena prakarana sakshi rupa atma swayam prakasha rupa bhati iti siddhyati. So in this manner, what happens is that the sakshi rupa atma, who is not a pramata, because he has an upadhi of antakarana, not a visheshana, that sakshi rupa atma, brahma chaitanya, swayam prakasha rupa bhati iti siddhyati, does not need phalavyapti, does not need the vrittigata chidabhasa rupa phala. Vritti is needed. Vritti is needed to take away the avarana. But for the phalana, vritti phalana, for vritti phalana, the chidabhasa, which otherwise is useful to shine up the vishaya, is no longer needed. So what happens? The ajnana taking away avarana, the vishaya, which is sakshi, shines up on its own. Sorry for a little noise. My chair, you know, gets stuck at times. So that was the 218th avarana. Very elaborate explanation. Each and every detail left nothing to doubt. So sadhu has left nothing to doubt in the 218th avarta, explaining the entire prakriya of Vedantic perception. Prakriya of perception. How? Methodology of Vedantic perception. Including in Brahma, Brahma Jnana, what takes place. So the next set of avartas, 219 to 223, are about Indriya Sambandham Vina Aham Brahma Iti Jnanasya Katham Pratyakshata Iti Tattva Drushti Prashnaha. He says, sir, you have explained this. I understand all that. So Pratyaksha Jnana Prama needs Jnana as means Pramana, which happens to be Indriya. So for Pratyaksha Prama to take place, Sadhanam Kim? Sadhanam is Pratyaksha Pramanam. What is that Pratyaksha Pramanam? It is Indriya. Now Indriya Sambandham Vina Aham Brahma Iti Jnanasya Katham Pratyakshata. How can there be Pratyaksha Jnana, Aparoksha Jnana, in the case of Brahmatma? I am Brahma. Aham Brahma, that jnana should take place. Now Indriya Sambandha is not there. Brahma cannot have Indriya Sambandha. Then how can there be Pratyakshata of such Brahmakara jnana, Brahma jnana? Iti Tattva Drishti Prashnaha. Tattva Drishti asks this. So Tattva Drishti Shanka is what is elaborated. Tattva Drishti Shanka. Brahma Paroksha Jnanena Sakala Vidya Samuha Nashyati. natu paroksha jnanine iti pragabhitam. He says earlier you have taught that brahma aparoksha jnana is needed through which sakala avidya samuha, the entire avidya conglomerate is destroyed, nashyati. Natu paroksha jnanine, aparoksha jnana is needed, not paroksha jnana. So aparoksha jnana is what? Pratyaksha. Another word for aparoksha jnana is pratyaksha. Paroksha jnana is brahma asti. Something is talked about somewhere, someone talks about it, I trust that person, whether it is guru or shruti, comes from some source, I trust the author. Here author is Ishvara, so to say. So Vedanta Vakya and Guru is also teaching that Brahma Asti. I have no doubts there. It is Paroksha Jnana. Avidya is not taken away by Paroksha Jnana. Only by Aparoksha Jnana it is taken away. So Brahma Asti, Paroksha Jnana does not work for me. Avantara Vakya does not work for me. I need a Mahavakya, Aham Brahma Asmi. I need Asmi, Uttama Purusha. Jinganta padam I need, without which the vakya will not give me aparoksha jnana. So aparoksha jnana, otherwise called as pratyaksha, is needed for me to have avidya cessation. Cessation of avidya. Atra esha shanka bhavati. Now there is a doubt. Indriya janyatvam eva jnanam pratyaksham ityuchyate. You have taken an example and you explained, but then indriya janyatvam is there in pratyaksha prama. Brahma jnanam tu na indriya janyam avishayatvad brahmanah. Brahma is not a vishaya for indriya. Indriyasya brahmana avishayatvad brahma jnanam indriya janyam na bhavati. And this is Tarka. What is the basis for it? I'll trace it back to Shruti says Tattva Drishti Yato Vacho Nivartante Aprapya Manasa Saha Ityadi Shrutehe. Shruti itself says that Yataha Yasmat Yasmat Brahmanaha At Brahmatmanaha Vachaha Manasa Saha Nivartante. How? Aprapya Brahma Aprapya Atmanam Aprapya. So Yasmat Brahmatmanaha Brahmatmanam Aprapya Manasasaha Vachaha Nivartante. So the words as well as the mind. Words is a Upalakshana for all Indriyas. All Indriyas written, including the mind, which can handle so many subtle things, but it cannot handle the subtle Brahmatma, the subtlest of the, subtler than the subtlest of Vishayas, Vastus. It returns, all these Indriyas return, the mind also returns. Returns meaning it cannot objectify. So when Brahma is not a Vishaya for the Indriya or Manaha, then how can there be pratyakshatvam? Because sadhana is lacking. Indriya is pramana. Pramana is lacking. Sadhana is lacking. You cannot have sadhya, prama, pratyaksha prama. Brahmana jnanendriyanam vishayaha. You are right, says the guru. It is not the vishaya. Brahma, I, aham, atma is not a vishaya for indriyas. Jnanendriya vishayas. Vishaya, Brahma isn't, Atma isn't. Brahmana Chakshusha Vishaya. Now these are, we can go through these quite fast because we know this, why it is not the Vishaya of Chakshu. Some reasoning has been given. Initially, an elaboration is there. Other Indriyas are clubbed together in a couple of avartas. Rupa Vatak Padartasya Athva Neeladi Varanasya Eva Jnanam Chakshusha Janyate. So Brahma is not the Vishaya for eyesight. Why so? Vision. For vision, Brahma is not the Vishaya because Indriya, Chakshur Indriya, grasps only Rupa. Only Rupa can be known by Chakshur Indriya. So, Rupa Vatah Padartasya Athva Neeladi Varana Seva. So, Rupa, if you take it as form or Neeladi Varana, form or color is objectified by the sight. ज्ञानम चक्षुषा जन्यते, ओनली दैट काइंड ऑफ ज्ञानम, कलर और शेप कैन बी नोन, फॉर्म कैन बी नोन बाय द आईसाइट. ब्रह्म तु न तादृशम, ब्रह्म इज नॉट तादृशम, मीन्स व्हाट, इज नॉट रूपवान रूपवत, ब्रह्म इज न्यूट्रल. सो ब्रह्म तु न तादृशम रूपवत, अतः रूपवत और नीलादि वर्णवत, डज नॉट हैव एनी कलर और फॉर्म शेप, देयरफॉर अतः न ब्रह्म नेत्रेन्द्रिय जन्य ज्ञान विषय. सो ब्रह्म इज नॉट एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर नेत्रेन्द्रिय. मनुष्याकारेण, नाउ दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, ओके, मनुष्याकारेण अवतीर्णानां रामकृष्णादीनां मूर्तय यद्यपि रूपादिमत्यः तथापि तामूर्तयः मायिकत्वात् मिथ्या. Now contextually, you know, somehow he's explaining, he takes a detour from the main topic. This is incidental, but it is very interesting. This kind of detail cannot be found elsewhere. At least I have not come across elsewhere, not even in Gita, you know, in Bhashya and Tika also. Some explanation is given, but then it is in keep, even the sadhu will say here, Anandagiri Tika also talks about what is avatara and avatara shariras. All this is discussed, but then it is very laukika description, in the sense that based on the audience, the description is given. So idam ittham, if you want to talk about this is how exactly it is, then what exactly is Ishwara Sharira when there is an avatara? Ishwara Sharira, avatara Sharira. We say Rama is Ishwara, Krishna is Ishwara. All these are avataras. These avataras are seen. So he is fitting it in the context, explaining Ishwara, Brahma. Brahma is also called as Ishwara, Saguna Brahma. Saguna Brahma is objectified by Manaha. Now he says this Saguna Brahma can be objective. Brahma is Rama Brahma, is Krishna Brahma. Being Ishwara, yes, we have to say yes. Then are they seen? Rama was seen. Rama was seen when born. He was seen by Mother Kaushalya, Dasharatha. He was seen. Was Krishna seen? Oh, Krishna was seen by everyone. He, you know, Rama was maybe seen by only few. He didn't roam around in among masses, except for in his 14 years of Vanavasa and his Ayodhya Nagara or whatever. As a king, whoever can see the king, they have seen the king. In his forest journey, whoever he came across, they have seen him. But Krishna is seen by everyone. He roamed around in public just like another person. He was not a king per se. We say prince, of course, but then he roamed around with everyone. He had Leela. So Rama and Krishna were seen by which indriyas now? So this can be a question, you know. So he brings that into a context and explains avataras. What are avataras? What are avatara shariras? What are they made of? Are they same or not? This question is there. There is a debate. You know, generally, people think about it. Now, when you talk about Krishna Janma, then people who follow some Puranas, particularly, they object to it. How can Krishna have a Janma? He is not born out of a womb. So they have these objections. So it has kind of resolved here, giving a perspective from Purana also, and seeing that they are objectifiable, there is some basis to it. But how does it fit this context? Because Chakshu Vishaya is being refuted for Brahma. Being Chakshu Vishaya is being refuted. Now, Ishwara is Brahma. Rama, Krishna, Ityadi, these are all avataras of Ishwara. And they were objectified by Chakshu Indriya, by everyone who were present around. So, Manushyakarena, when Ishwara, Brahma takes Manushyakara, Manushyakarena avatirnanam, those who have taken such avatara, Manushyavatara, who are those Rama, Krishna, Ityadi? Murtayaha. they are called as murtis now. Ramakrishnadinam murtaya, they are shariras. So murtaya yadyapi rupadi matyaha. They are rupadi mat. Rama sharira, Krishna sharira had rupa ityadi. Therefore, there can be a question as to how can Brahma not be Indriya Vishya, Ramakrishna are Indriya Vishya. Tathapi ta murtaya mayikatvat mithya. The murti is mithya. Ramakrishna murti is mithya. Sharira is mithya. Ataha nata murtaya brahmarupaha. So if you say Ramakrishna are Brahma, yes, Rama and Krishna are Brahma, but what exactly do we say Rama when we say Rama is Brahma? Not the Rama Sharira. Rama Sharira is not Brahma. Why? Mayikatvat. Mithya. What about Krishna Sharira? Mayikatvat. Mithya. So ataha nata murtayaha brahmarupa. So what you see is murti. You see the sharira. All those around saw the Rama sharira, Krishna sharira. Rama murti, Krishna murti. Did not see Brahma. So Brahma is not chakshu vishaya. The murti sharira is chakshu vishaya and that is mithya. Brahma is satya. Satya Brahma cannot be objectified by chakshu. Ataha nata murtaya brahma rupa yadyavi puranadishu ramakrishnadinam brahma rupena varana namasti tathapi tadvachanam na tadiya sharirasya brahmatva buddhya pravruttam kintu tadiya shariradishthana chaitanyasya brahmatva buddhya eva iti jneyam. So when Puranas talk about Ramakrishna as Brahma, all avatars as Brahma, still that is not about the Sharira. Their Sharira is not being talked about as Brahma. What is the Brahmatva Buddhi in? Not in the Rama Sharira, Krishna Sharira, but Sharira Gata Chaitanya. Sharira Adhishthana Chaitanya. So Rama, Sharira Adhishthana Chaitanya, Krishna Sharira Adhishthana Chaitanya. All these are descriptions given with that Adhishthana Chaitanya is in mind, which is Brahma. Sattva Drishti is very sharp. As soon as he hears that, he says, what is this? Shariragata Chaitanya in Ramakrishna is not different from Shariragata Chaitanya in a Pashupakshi or a Manushya. It's the same. Adhishthana Chaitanya is not different. This is the teaching you have given me. Now you are saying that Ramakrishna Adhishthana Chaitanya is Brahma, not the Ramakrishna Sharira. Then what is the difference between Adhishthana Chaitanya and Rama, Krishna and me, or in any Pashupakshi? So he puts a question there. Nanu Manushya Pashupakshyadi Sarva Shariranam Api Adhishthanam Brahma Chaitanyam Eva. For all Manushya, Pashu and Pakshi also, all these are Shariras. Manushya Sharira, Pashu Sharira, Pakshadi Sharira. For all these Shariras, Sarva Shariranam Api Adhishthanam Brahma Chaitanya. Adhishthana is Chaitanya, Brahma Chaitanya alone. There is no other Chaitanya. Adhishthana Chaitanya Abhiprayana Ramakrishna Adinam Brahmatve Sati. If you say Puranadishu in Puranas, or elsewhere, wherever Rama and Krishna are talked about as avatars, as Brahma, that time if you say Adhishthana Chaitanya Abhipraya is there in calling them as Brahma, then Sarva Shariranam Api Brahma Chaitanya Seva Adhishthana Tvat Manushya Pashupakshyadeha Api Brahma Rupa Bhaveyu. Then why would they alone be called as Brahma? Everyone can be called as Brahma. Pashu, Pakshi, Manushya, all are Brahma. Do we use that kind of, you know, you are arguing with someone, you are calling him names. Are you calling that person as Brahma? You cannot call Pashu, Pakshi as Brahma. Maybe some, you know, very, very respected, your own mother, your own guru, somebody you have heard about, you know, in Puranas ityadi, you can call them as Brahma, but every Tom, Dick and Harry cannot be called as Brahma. They will also become Brahma Rupa. Brahma Rupa Bhaveyu. तथा च पश्वादि समाय रामकृष्णादि भवेयु. सो इट इज वेरी शॉकिंग दैट रामकृष्ण विल ऑल्सो बिकम लाइक पशु पक्षी बिकॉज एवरी वन इज ब्रह्म. तस्माद् रामकृष्णादीनां जीवांतरापेक्षया वैशिष्ट्य सिद्धये तदीय शरीरे ब्रह्म बुद्धिरुचिता. देयरफॉर देयर इज सम वैशिष्ट्य. दैट वैशिष्ट्य इज इन शरीर, इट इज नॉट इन ब्रह्म चैतन्य. ब्रह्म चैतन्य इज द सेम. सो रामकृष्ण स्पेसिफिकली बीइंग कॉल्ड एज ब्रह्म इज ड्यू टू शरीर, इट इज नॉट ड्यू टू ब्रह्म चैतन्य विद इन. विच इज वाई वी डू नॉट कॉल एवरी मनुष्य एवरी पशु पक्षी एज ब्रह्मा, बट वी कॉल रामकृष्ण एज ब्रह्मा. तस्माद् रामकृष्णादीनां जीवांतरापेक्षया कंपेयर टू अदर जीवास दे आर कॉल्ड एज ब्रह्मा बिकॉज वैशिष्ट सिद्धये तदीय शरीर ब्रह्म बुद्धिरुचिता. इस शरीर इज स्पेसिफिक एंड देर फोर ब्रह्म बुद्धि शुड बी इन शरीर ऑफ रामकृष्ण. एंड इफ इट इज अ ब्रह्म बुद्धि देर देन शरीर इज चक्षुरिंद्रिय विषया. देयरफॉर ब्रह्मा विल बिकम चक्षुरिंद्र विषया, चक्षुरिंद्रिय विषया. न तु तदीय शरीराधिष्ठान चैतन्य दृष्ट्या तेषु ब्रह्म बुद्धिर इति चेत. इफ दिस इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन दैट ब्रह्म चैतन्य इज नॉट द रीजन दैट रामकृष्ण अधिष्ठान ब्रह्म चैतन्य इज नॉट द रीजन फॉर देम टू बी कॉल्ड एज ब्रह्म बट इट इज थ्रू द शरीर दृष्टि, देन वॉट इज योर आंसर? Or he wants to know. He wants to know. Therefore, he is asking. I would like to know. Iti chet. We'll look at the answer in the next part. We are already overshot time. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namam adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher dripyaptimirmanam param sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak param maha tadeva nischitamatihi. Any questions? I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Hari Om.